Welcome back, everybody. It's your boy, Sean, the American in Krakow, and we're back here in the studio about to do another one of my gear reviews. Today, we're going to talk about the bags that I wear because I think I've talked about both of my bikes. I've got the Indian Scout Bobber, and I've got the FTR 1200S, neither of which are known for any form of storage capacity. And my bikes are my daily, get around. I go shopping with them, groceries, the mall, whatever. That's how I get around as long as the weather's good. Of course, if I need to do something big, I will take the car, but that's pretty rare. So the first bag that we want to talk about today, which was my primary bag, especially if I was trying to get around town and I was kind of in a spicy mood and really wanted to get around town, this would be my Kriega R20. And I've got this right here. So this is the Kriega R20. It's not a very big bag. The 20 literally stands for 20 liters. And it will take the 20 liters. As you can see, it'll open up. It'll take quite a bit. I've carried quite a bit in this bag. The first thing I want to comment about, which is why it's no longer my daily use bag, is it's only weather resistant, meaning it's not guaranteed to be waterproof. Now, I have ridden it with it in light rain, and I've been reasonably okay. But the problem I have is both of my bikes have no rear fender. That rear tire throws up a lot of water. It comes right up onto the bottom of the bag. And I have had water soak through and actually pool on the inside of this bag. It's not their fault that I don't run fenders on my bike. So that's not a knock on them. And they don't advertise it as waterproof. They do advertise it as water resistant. And that it is. So let's break this bag down a little bit real quick. So the bag itself is standard Kriega design, which is pretty well thought through with all kinds of places to strap and ratchet the bag down. They're never shy about their branding. They've got their K right in the middle of the bag here, but it's a reflective patch. The R20 is also a reflective patch. And there's a couple of other reflective touches that are around the bag. Back around the back here, we're gonna talk about the straps. Kriega, in my opinion, has one of the most comfortable strapping systems out there. So we'll start off with the straps themselves. They are fully adjustable. They have kind of a marking system on straps here, and you can adjust that up and down. Once you've got that piece sorted out, then you can adjust out from the bottom for the quad lock. And this quad lock is phenomenal. I mean, once you get this snapped across your sternum, that's locked in there, and you can then snug it down. There's two straps here, you just give it a yank. It'll snug the bag down, and this bag will never move from you. It takes all the weight and it distributes it from the lower back, the shoulder, and the chest. So even if you've got the bag loaded up, it's not just going to be a ton of weight sitting on your shoulders like a normal backpack. So let's move on to the inside of the bag, which is another kind of reason why I don't use this bag anymore. It's a single compartment bag, right? There's nothing here. There's no organizer. There's nothing. There is one kind of pouch in the back, but it's not really designed for being an organizer. It can carry the, you can put a water bladder in there. You can put a back protector in there. Or I do know for a fact that a 13-inch MacBook Pro in a sleeve will fit in there. So that's where I used to carry my laptop. Then you have the main pouch. And then right on the inside of the outer cover, there is this plastic. You can kind of see through it, but you can still see in there, and you can kind of put papers in there, paper, pen, whatever you need quick access to. And then finally, just on the outside, there is a quick access pouch, and it runs the full length or height of the bag. Again, definitely not going to be waterproof. That will be the first thing that gets soaked in there. Well, once you've got the bag loaded, you've got it, because you might see it here, there's a bunch of buckles all around the bag. These buckles will actually let you clip them in and then ratchet the bag down. So depending on what kind of load you have in there, if I do my groceries and I've got milk and juice in there, you don't want to necessarily have all that thing swaying around on your back, especially if you're being a little aggressive on the bike. So once you get your load in there, you zip it up, you can ratchet these down and it locks everything in the bag down. It really is a great bag. My only big concern or my only kind of gripe with it, it wasn't waterproof, really. And then when I started dealing with the weather here in Poland, which is a little bit more unpredictable, especially if I headed a little bit, you know, if I was going south towards the mountains where it can rain at any given time, I did end up switching to Kriega's. It is again a Kriega. If nothing else, I am brand loyal. Actually, I just love their bags. They work really well for me and they last. As you can see, this is also a very well-used bag. This is their Kriega messenger bag. And I believe it's the Kriega, there's two. There's the EDC, everyday carry. And then there's this messenger bag. And the primary difference is this is also just one, predominantly one big pouch. But with Kriega, when you see this white liner on the inside, which is a removable liner, right there, it velcros in really well. Yeah, see, it's a removable liner. This is 100% waterproof. I have carried my laptop, just my passport, everything in here, and ridden through torrential rain, and nothing gets wet. I'm soaked, but nothing in this bag gets wet. So one very large capacity storage area. It's all white, which helps when you're looking in because you get a high contrast, so you can easily identify and see things that are in the bag. And then once you get your bag loaded, it's a roll top design. So you give it 1, 2, 3 twists, and then you just make sure it's pressed all your air out. This is the only problem with roll tops. If you don't press the air out, it stays bulky. And then you just snap it into itself. Once those two snaps are done, this bag is fully waterproof. And then you have a cover. Just throw it right over, and that snaps up as well. And your bag is ready to go. And then on the back, they have a very padded and very grippy surface. So now this, a messenger bag, you usually just throw it over your shoulder and you're good to go. But when you're riding, you don't want it hanging on your side. You don't want it on your shoulder because then it can sway around. So this bag is designed to just actually just go right over your back. And because of their very unique, I have not seen it on any other bag, tightening system, this is something you do even with your helmet on. So if you forget to put it on and your helmet's already on, you can get this bag over your head. So when it's fully extended, you just lift it, you throw it over your back, and once you get it settled to where you want, you grab the ring, you give it a pull, and now with that texture on the back and whatever jacket you're wearing, that bag is not going to move. So if you're going very far or you're carrying a heavy load, it's not the most comfortable thing for long rides. But for beating around the city and knowing that everything in there is 100% waterproof, it's just good to go. That was my daily for going to work, carrying my laptop, carrying gear, extra shoes, anything I needed, threw everything in there. It fit really well, and I knew it was protected. Now to release, it's the same handle. You just give it a yank. Lift right over your head, again, even with the helmet on, and it's easy, it comes right off. So that's that Kriega, and again, they're not shy with their branding. And that's about it. This is what I would wear on a regular, just to beat around town, especially if I don't know what my plans are or what my goals are, what I'm gonna do. This is probably the bag I would beat around Krakow in. If I know I'm still gonna be beating around, but I'm feeling a little bit spicier, which is most of the time lately. I've actually got Kriega's new bag, which is their R18. It replaces their R20, I believe. I don't know if they make the R20 anymore, but it should be a direct replacement for the R20. But there are some differences and some advantages. So let me just get this out of the way and get this R18 up here. So here we go. Here is the Kriega R18. I'm sorry, it's not the R18. It is the T. They changed the line. So this is a T-series bag. It is the T18. And first things first, it's high-vis. It doesn't bother me. It's fine. But the first thing I want to call out right away is this mesh bungee strapped, which is life-changing for me. Like, I go to a gas station, I buy a bottle of water, buy a soda, a sandwich, my visor when I was wearing my Scorpion, and I had to carry an extra visor. I didn't always have to go digging into the bag it actually just threw it right in there. Pulled the little grip cord, tightened it up, stayed right there all day. Secondly, or the second big change on this is it's no longer one single compartment on the inside. So I'll start with the back of the bag. So there's a zipped area. And the zip starts about three quarters of the way up here and almost all the way to the bottom. So it opens kind of like that, you see it there. And this is, I believe, an 8 or 9 liter section. So it's obviously you're no longer able to carry one big mass of 20 liters like you could in the R20. Even this is no longer 20 liters, this is 18 liters. But you do have this outside, which makes more than makes up for any the 2 liters that you might have lost. In addition to that, there are two pouches right here. One is zipped, and it kind of goes all the way around. That's a small pouch, you can hold papers, wallet, keys, stuff like that. There is even a key hook in there, a quick release key hook. And then just above that, it's the same kind of pouch, it's all one piece, as you see that white liner, you know that means it's waterproof, a fully waterproofed pouch. And again, because it's a waterproof, it's a roll top, these just strap down to the side. Again, you try to give it three turns. Three turns is kind of that magic number with roll tops. And strap it in, waterproof. Now, we get to the second part, the second compartment. And it's rolling. It's got a white liner. That means it is fully waterproof, and it's that full length of the bag, and it can take quite a bit. I think this one is 10, I believe it's the mix, or it's the other way around, but I get more than my daily gear in there, and because it's waterproof, the MacBook fits right in there, in its sleeve. I can throw a light jacket, or a pair of shoes. Well, usually I'll throw shoes in there. Just all the gear I need goes right in here. All the primary gear I want to make sure doesn't get wet. Anything I'm not too worried about or concerned about potentially getting wet goes back here. And I am good to go. The straps are exactly the same as the R20 with the adjustment system, the quad lock, and the straps to ratchet it, you know, just tighten it, cinch it down to your sides. This is the bag I carry when I'm carrying my cameras and my gear, if I'm out vlogging, when I'm doing any of the moto vlogs, I put all the other camera gear and recording gear, it's in here all the time in the waterproof section. I never have to worry about it. So this is my go-to now. Again, the Kriega T18. So I will put a link to the shop where I bought all of my Kriega gear. And then for those of you outside of Poland, I'll try to put some links up on Amazon. Those will be affiliate links. So if you do feel like purchasing, please, if you can use that link, you know, it'll help support the channel. So I would definitely appreciate that. Anyway, that's going to be it for today. Thank you so much for joining. If you liked the video, hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe, join the family. We do things like this. We do moto vlogging. I do try to go out to different places to eat and give you a review. And, you know, just whatever else is on my mind that day while I'm riding around. And I will also do occasionally some reviews on my tech gear, like my cameras, my lights, things like that as well. Thanks again. Hit the like button. Please subscribe. Check out my Instagram. The link will be in the outro. And peace.